Hello and welcome. I'm Dr. Martin, and in this video, we'll review an interesting head and neck radiology case. Today's case involves a teenage girl who presents with a painless anterior neck mass. A contrast-enhanced CT scan of the neck was ordered to further evaluate this finding. On the left side of the screen, we have axial CT images. Here you can see a well-defined, lobulated, hypodense lesion indicated by the arrow. There is no peripheral enhancement after contrast administration, confirming its cystic appearance. Let's now look at the sagittal reconstructions on the right. We can clearly identify the lesion located just inferior to this structure, the hyoid bone. To be more specific, it lies between the hyoid and the thyroid cartilage. Returning to the axial images, the lesion is in the midline, embedded within the anterior soft tissues of the neck. It also appears to be nestled between the infrahyoid muscles, also known as the strap muscles. This detail is important for identifying its anatomical track. Interestingly, this lesion has two components. The first is extracervical, in the midline anterior neck soft tissues. But there is also a second component extending into the supraglottic larynx, occupying the preepiglottic space. You can visualize this extension more clearly in the sagittal views. The cyst extends from the anterior neck into the larynx through the space between the hyoid bone and the thyroid cartilage, an area corresponding to the thyrohyoid membrane. So, we're dealing with a lesion that spans both superficial and deep anatomical compartments. Before we reveal the final diagnosis, don't forget to subscribe to the channel, hit the like button, and turn on notifications. This helps us reach more viewers interested in radiologic anatomy and pathology of the head and neck. The diagnosis in this case is a thyroglossal duct cyst with extension into the preepiglottic space. Let's review some key facts about thyroglossal duct cysts. These are embryological remnants of the thyroglossal tract and are the most common congenital midline neck masses. On imaging, they typically appear as well-defined cystic lesions along the midline. They can be located anywhere from the base of the tongue at the foramen cecum to the lower anterior neck below the hyoid bone. 50% are found at the level of the hyoid, 20 to 25% in the suprahyoid region, and another 25% in the infrahyoid region. In our patient, the cyst is infrahyoid and midline, with extension into the preepiglottic space, an unusual but recognized finding. Thyroglossal duct cysts may also appear paramedian, especially when trapped between strap muscles, but they are never truly lateral. If you encounter a cystic lesion away from the midline, consider an alternative diagnosis. Typically, the cyst wall shows no enhancement or only minimal enhancement after contrast. When infected, enhancement becomes more pronounced. If you see internal solid nodules or calcifications, consider the possibility of malignant transformation. Differential diagnoses include lymphatic malformations, dermoid or epidermoid cysts, lingual thyroid, sublingual or submandibular abscess, laryngocele, Delphian lymph node necrosis. Embryologically, the thyroid gland originates at the foramen cecum in the third gestational week. By the seventh week, it descends along the thyroglossal duct to reach its final position anterior to the laryngeal cartilages. Involution of the duct occurs between the 8th and 10th weeks. Failure of this involution leads to cyst formation due to retained epithelial secretions. Clinically, these cysts present as painless, midline neck masses that move with tongue protrusion. They may become painful if infected. They are typically diagnosed in children or young adults and require surgical excision. The procedure of choice is the cyst trunk operation, which includes removal of the central portion of the hyoid bone and complete excision of the thyroglossal tract up to the foramen cecum to reduce recurrence. If you're interested in another cystic lesion in head and neck imaging, I recommend watching our video on the imaging findings of a Tornwaldt cyst. It's a helpful complement to this case. You'll find the link to that video in the comments section below. Thanks for watching. Stay tuned for more head and neck radiology content here on Dr. Martin, Head and Neck Radiology. See you in the next case.